Hey everybody, I'm Veljko, and in this video I'm gonna be telling you the full story of how I ended up buying this car. I think it's an interesting story and it's worth to hear. So without further ado, let's go way back to 2013 when I bought my first car. And this is where we start. This is a Toyota Corolla T-Sport from 2003. I bought it in 2013 on August 10th. I think I was only 18 years old when I bought it, so I was pretty young and I fell in love with it. And how can I not? For a first car to have nearly 200 horsepower and for the engine, the naturally aspirated engine, to rev up to 8,200 RPMs, I had a blast in this car. But then 3 years ago, in 2016, my other YouTube channel, which is a gaming channel, I will put a link somewhere if you want to know, that channel blew up. I was getting, on every of my videos, I was getting millions of views. So I was earning not a lot, but enough for me to think of upgrading my car. And I was thinking, what car should that be? Because I still had no idea. My dream car was a Mitsubishi Lancer Evolution 10. But of course, that car is not cheap. I mean, I was earning a lot on that channel, but not that much. So I was searching on the internet on used cars to see what can be a nice upgrade from my Toyota. And I come across a Mitsubishi Lancer Rally Art. It's the same generation like the Lancer Evolution 10. It's just, it doesn't have as much power, the turbo is different, and it doesn't have the wide body kit and the big spoiler at the back. Then I found one in my country that's on sale. It's like the orange Mitsubishi Lancer Rally Art. And I asked my dad to try to check it and see if I'm gonna fall in love with. Now that was in 2017, so I can't remember in detail, but I think the seller was pricing it at around 17,000 euros, which still isn't cheap, but why not to test drive it, and maybe later on I'm gonna find a cheaper one, because that one was equipped with so many things, so that's why the price is so high. And the overall condition was in, I would say, mint condition, like it was really nicely kept. So we came there and I loved how it looks in real person. That orange color really pops. I've tried it in corners and it handles very well. It has, of course, all-wheel drive still, and 240 horsepower isn't small. I was in love, but not that much. It has the dual clutch transmission. I was scared of the reliability of that transmission, and when I went on YouTube to do a bit of research of the other people's ownership, and many of them were actually showing little clips of that transmission going into limp mode or something, and the reliability not being very good. So I was like thinking, like, I don't know, like maybe I don't want to, because I'm gonna spend so much money at the start, I don't want to have also a risk of more problems with the transmission or all-wheel drive system. I also heard the maintenance for that transmission is also very expensive. So that kind of threw me off, and my love for it kind of died a little bit, and I was still looking for some other options on the market that would suit what I want. Then later on that year, 2017, I came across a Lexus IS250. It was in a white pearl color, same like mine, and it was on sale for I think like 7,000 euros. So it was way cheaper than a Mitsubishi Lancer Rally Art. So I did a bit more research, and I've seen on YouTube that the transmission wasn't very fast. It's a traditional automatic transmission, and that kind of threw me off. Like, I kind of still wanted to have a manual transmission, but because that white Lexus that was on sale was 10 minutes away from us, me and my dad decided to go check it out just to see. Now when we were going there, my expectations were not really high, because in the pictures the car doesn't look like so amazing. But when we came there, like, I don't know if it was the weather and that white pearl color that pops during the cloudy weather, but I will never forget that day when I saw that Lexus IS250 in person for the first time. when I saw that Lexus, my jaw like dropped on the floor of how beautiful the car was. Now, many Americans would now question, like, what? We have so many Lexuses here. But I live in Europe and I think I've never seen a Lexus before that moment. Or maybe I've seen it, but I wasn't paying attention because I wasn't planning to buy it at that time. So it was kind of like my first time seeing the car. And boy, like, I fell in love with the looks. I think it looks way better than the Mitsubishi Rally Art. To explain you better, I came to my famous place where I record my cars just to show you the beauty of this car. Now, in contrast to the Lancer Rally Art, which was like a higher and more narrow car, this just gives it such a wide presence on the road. Like, look at this detail here after the headlight. It looks like it has a wide body kit already. I so adore it. In person, again, I'm repeating the 1,000 times, in person it looks 10 times better than in pictures. At the back, like, nothing crazy, just a nice head. It's a timeless design, if you ask me. It's a really, and when I stamp into the interior, you feel the quality everywhere, outside and inside. I wasn't disappointed as well. So when you start on the engine, it just, there's this nice animation, there's a soft touch materials, you sit very low, the windows are thin, and it gives you it feels like you're in a cockpit. And yeah, speakers like everywhere, you see the quality everywhere, like when you open this, the way it opens. And that Lexus that I went to see didn't have these seats, it had the leather, perforated leather. And I'm not kidding, my butt never sat on a more comfortable seat. This material here is so soft, it's like Alcantara or velour material, also on the roof. Like, I don't know, I truly fell in love, and at that point I thought this is the car to have. Apologies, my car is very dirty, but as you can see, the color is also a white pearl color, and I love it. I think it's the best color for this car. And getting to the engine, it has a 208 horsepower, and the way it pulls, like, it has a lot of power in the lower RPMs. Also, it's a rear-wheel drive and a V6, so who doesn't love a V6 engine? That also made me want it even more. But back to that white Lexus on sale. When we were inspecting the car a little bit, I saw that that car wasn't in good condition. There were so many panels that was painted, and it wasn't in white pearl. Like, some side was a regular white color. And also I think the trunk couldn't open, but I still fell in love. But my parents were telling me, like, you will find a better one, you just have to wait a little bit. But the thing is, like, here in Serbia, the Lexus IS250s are so rare that I couldn't wait for Lexus IS250 in a better condition. So I was still like hooked on just buying that one that you see. And thankfully I listened to my parents, because that's not the Lexus that I ended up buying. And after that, it's been like 1 year of me waiting. There was one black IS250 that looked good, but it wasn't also registered. It wasn't being driven, and it gave me the feeling of, like, maybe the owner didn't do proper maintenance on the car. Then on August, beginning of August 2018, another white IS250 came on sale. The owner priced it at 7,000 euros. And from the pictures that I'm gonna show you now, it looked in way better condition than the first IS250. And inside, it's not a luxury pack, this is like a sport package, which to me, it's like even better. And when I was scrolling to pictures and seeing the car that's on sale, I thought, okay, this is the one. It has everything that I need. It doesn't have the multimedia that just creates more problems and overcomplicates things. It has the Alcantara interior, which I like. The color is the best white pearl that I like. It has, I'm gonna show you some few scratches, but I'm not too OCD when it comes to scratches. That's something that can be always fixed later on. So me and my dad went to see that Lexus a few days after it's been posted on the internet that's on sale. And because that car was registered, I can take it for a test drive, and honestly, it surpassed my expectations while driving. The car drives so smooth. This V6 engine is such a smooth engine, and the isolation over bumps, there was zero rattles in this car. And finally, the transmission. Now, I noticed the upshifts are not very, it's delayed, you can say, but the downshifts are pretty quick. And I thought the downshifts are more important than upshifts, if you ask me. So I wasn't amazed of the transmission, but I wasn't disappointed as well. And then I thought, well, I have my Toyota, which is a manual car, and if I miss a manual shifting gears, then I can just go to the Toyota and enjoy myself, and I'm gonna use this car for travel. So honestly, it checked every box that I wanted, and the pricing was excellent. We even lowered it to 6,500 euros. It also came with the winter set wheels and tires, so I'm like, it's a bargain. I mean, this is such a quality product, and for that price, I couldn't say no. Now, it was interesting how we lowered the price. He didn't want to accept the 6,500 euros, but when he heard my name is Veliko, he thought, oh my God, like my son that I'm waiting is also gonna be called Veliko. So he's like, okay, fine. And that's how he accepted our offer. I am recording this on Tuesday, 23rd of August at 9 p.m. and tomorrow it's gonna be a special day for me. I just can't believe it and also can't wait at the same time. So tomorrow me and my dad, we will go and receive the car, but first we have to be done with all the paperwork. It's crazy, like I can't believe it. I had my first car for 5 years and this is the moment. I did see it in person and tested it and I fell in love. It's like it's made for me. And also, I've never seen that car in pearl white during the night. I can't wait to see that. I'm gonna go sleep now and tomorrow is gonna be a very happy day. Okay, so I just woke up. Now I'm gonna go there with my dad. I hope with all the paper it's gonna go smooth, and yeah, let's go. Okay, I'm back and I just did a like 10 kilometer drive on a highway. So far I'm loving it, and it's a true luxury and sporty vehicle. Like I have butterflies in my stomach. Now we are at Toyota and they're gonna do a check on my car, see if there's anything wrong. The color is amazing and the wheels too. You simply feel special driving it. And yes, the papers are all done and it's officially my car. This is like a leap above the Toyota, and oh, it's amazing. This is my new car and my dad is driving my old car. So yeah, now we're heading home finally in my new Lexus. And this is my first fill-up. Looking awesome in the dark. And yeah, after 1 year of waiting, I finally got what I wanted. And I am so happy, like the realization when I bought this car. So I don't know what else to tell you. I mean, you can see I'm very happy after 2.5 years of owning this car. Lastly, I wanted to show you Destiny at work. Here I am in 2014 Belgrade Car Show. Back then I didn't even know much about Lexus, but when I saw that IS250, I really loved the design. So much that I made a video showcasing it. Thank you for listening to my story till the end, and stay tuned for more. Take care.